What's up everyone, OSes here. Today I'm going to walk you through a workaround I found for making my old Voodoo 3 PCI the primary video card on my Ryzen 9 3900X setup. This is a fix for AMI BIOS systems, which are practically on every motherboard these days and should work with any PCI video card and a modern AMD motherboard. On newer motherboards, you can easily switch between the integrated graphics IGD and your PCI Express PEG card. But if you have more than one discrete card, you're out of luck. There is no direct option to choose which one should be primary. This setting is very important for older operating systems like Windows 98. Here, what the BIOS sets as the primary card is locked in and you can't change it in the OS. That's why this workaround is crucial for anyone trying to run Windows 9X on newer hardware. Supposing you want the primary card to be compatible with Windows 9X and maybe use a more powerful GPU with Windows 10 or newer in a multi-boot setup. There is a plan B, the card placed in the top PCI Express 16X slot will be used by default for booting. This is pretty standard for modern motherboards. Knowing this, we can use a PCI to PCI Express adapter and force the system to use our PCI card. But this adds a bulk, making the card non-standard in height, and we might not be able to secure the card in place. Additionally, if we have only one PCI Express 16X slot, we can say goodbye to a secondary, more powerful GPU. This wasn't a complicated job until recently. For example, on this H81 motherboard for Intel 4th gen CPUs, we can select our primary video card between PCI, PCI Express, or integrated graphics. Even better, on this AMI BIOS for an HP workstation, the graphics cards are listed by the slot they occupy, and we can pick the exact card we want as primary. This made it easy for me to switch between the same Voodoo 3 PCI and an RTX 2060 card. By the way, the RTX card couldn't handle one of my favorite DOS games. Let me show you a shortcut from one of my older videos. At this moment, I select the NVIDIA VGA controller as a primary video card. I boot into DOS and guess what?
No.
Alright, time for some reggae throwback to set the vibe. While that plays, let me show you how I got my PCI Voodoo to act as primary video card, while I'll also give you some context along the way. So, a while ago, I upgraded to a fresh Ryzen 9 3900X and I wanted a motherboard that still had classic PCI slots. After some research, I ended up with the BIOSTAR X470 GTA, which has two classic PCI slots. Naturally, I was curious to see if my old PCI Voodoo 3 card would work with this modern setup. And guess what? Here is my Voodoo 3 booting up just fine. Let's take a quick look at this very fast Windows 95.
About 7 seconds. I guess it's fine.
So my Voodoo 3 was working just fine. Great. However, I wasn't planning to use all this hardware for Windows 9X, so I installed an RTX 2070 Super as my main GPU. That's when the surprise hit. The BIOS automatically set the RTX card as the primary video card. No problem, I'll just go into BIOS and I'll boot with my PCI video card. That was always an option. But guess what? This option just wasn't there. And I did look everywhere. Next, I contacted the customer support to ask where this basic option had gone. Where?
Dear customer, according to your question, this model only can set the primary display to PCIe slot or IGD. If you install devices at PCIe and PCI, it will boot from PCIe first. Sorry for any inconvenience. Have a nice day and wish you a Merry Christmas season.
Well, that must be it. The primary card on a modern system can only be a PCIe card. It seems like a technical limitation, but it didn't make much sense, especially when using legacy mode. Then I had this idea. Since there is no integrated graphics, the BIOS didn't show up the option to switch from the integrated to PCI Express. But what if I force this option to appear and select integrated graphics as the boot option? That's when I stumbled across AMI's configuration tool, AMI BCP. Officially, it's not a tool available to the public, but it's what manufacturers use to customize their BIOS releases. So I decided to dive in and check if I could find any settings related to primary video card. And I did. Next, in the graphics configuration menu, I enabled all the available settings. To do this, I had to change the access type from the default to a higher privilege level, like a supervisor. Normally changing the access type at the top menu is enough, but I decided to manually adjust it for every option, just to be sure. Afterward, I flashed the new custom BIOS with the built-in BioFlasher utility. It worked like a charm. And what do you know? Magically, in the graphics configuration menu, a primary video device menu appeared. At this point, even with this menu enabled, I still wasn't sure if choosing a non-existent integrated graphics as the boot option would make the BIOS bypass the PCI Express card and use the next available adapter. Anyway, what could possibly go wrong? Well, what do you know? Turns out that my initial guess was spot on. After the next restart, my PCIe Voodoo 3 was put in charge and I simply couldn't believe it. The card is now handled by the Microsoft Basic Display Driver. Despite the name, this driver isn't as basic as it sounds. For instance, software OpenGL kicks in when launching an OpenGL compatible game like Quake 2, giving us around 34 frames per second at 1024 by 768. Now how about switching back my RTX card as primary in Windows 10? As I mentioned earlier, it's really easy to do it at the OS level. There are two options. I can either disable the Voodoo card in the control panel, or if I want to use just one display, I can simply instruct Windows to output everything to the monitor connected to the RTX card. And that's it. Obviously, there won't be much tinkering with a Voodoo 3 in Windows 10, but this card shines in a multi-boot setup, especially with its excellent driver support. In fact, Voodoo 3 has drivers for Windows 3.1 and even Windows NT 3.5.1, which is impressive. Not to mention that it's a perfect match for Windows NT 4, where you can enjoy a solid gaming performance with this card. That wraps it up for today. If you have any idea why AMI left out this basic option while filling modern BIOSes with tons of unnecessary settings, drop a comment below. I would love to hear your thoughts. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.